We have an entire concerto to play for you. We've taken a bold choice. We're going to perform for you the entire Elgar Cello Concerto with three different soloists, which is going to be very exciting. I will introduce them all. Now, just a little bit of medical background, because we are a medical orchestra. I find it interesting. I was reading about this particular piece, and it turns out that Elgar wrote this when he was about 61, and at the age of 60, so the year prior, he actually went in for surgery to have a tonsillectomy because he had a very inflamed and infected tonsil. Now, this was in the 1920s, before the advent of penicillin and antibiotics. So surgery, even though we have wonderful surgical colleagues, I love you all, was very dangerous when Elgar was having surgery because we didn't even have prophylaxis with things like antibiotics. But he survived, and it turns out when he came around from whatever form of anesthesia they gave him, the poor bugger, it definitely was not propofol, which is my favorite drug. When he awoke from this operation, he asked for a piece of paper and he penned the melody of the first movement of the cello concerto. So maybe we all need a bit more anesthesia in our lives. Anyway, this is a beautiful work. It was also made famous by a brilliant cellist by the name of Jacqueline Dupré. Anybody heard of Jacqueline Dupré? Yes. An amazingly gifted cellist who, tragically, also a medical link, was her life was cut short, as was her cello playing, by an autoimmune disease named multiple sclerosis. Her immune system attacked itself to the point where she couldn't play and then couldn't breathe and then died at the age of 42. Which is very sad. But literally, we credit, Western music credits Jacqueline Dupré with popularizing this cello concerto. Before then, it wasn't really that well known, but she brought it to life and made it so popular, it is now considered standard repertoire for concert cellists. And we have a concert cellist or two or three lined up for you. Our first one, you might like to get ready, Dr. Michael. Dr. Michael Lamb probably needs very little. Probably needs very little by way of introduction to this audience. Those of you who have ever come to hear the QMO before have probably heard Michael play and know how amazing he is. Michael had a life previously as a cellist, performing with the Queensland Symphony Orchestra and orchestras all around the world, and then decided, because he wanted to make some money, presumably, studied medicine so that he could have gainful employment. Are you gainfully employed? Yes, at the Sunshine Coast University Hospital, where he's a resident. And Michael is an incredibly gifted cellist, and he will be playing the first and second movements of the Elgar Cello Concerto with the Queensland Medical Orchestra. We hope you enjoy. Oh, that wasn't it.